A review of Netflix documentary Wild Wild Country, Rajneeshpuram, Cult or Utopia, my thoughts. Wild Wild Country is a documentary series premiered on Netflix recently. It has 6 episodes and tells the story of the controversial religious guru Rajneesh or Osho and the formation of the group's commune, Rajneeshpuram, in Oregon in the US. The documentary did not say whether what was happening in Rajneeshpuram is right or wrong. They go on presenting footages and people's opinion in this series. Some videos shown in this documentary may be disturbing for the public. When you know Osho, when you are aware of the activities and the context of these things, you will have one perspective. But to a man outside the commune, it may look like a demonic cult and weird stuff, you know. Some people even saw it as a sex cult. Let's get to the story. In 1981, Osho's American disciples purchased a 64,000-acre ranch in Oregon in the US, and a city called Rajneeshpuram was made. It served as a commune for people to visit and experience meditation. Very quickly, Rajneeshpuram became the largest spiritual community ever established in America. Osho was talking about the real face of priests and politicians and exposing them to the world. They both were against him. More and more people started settling down in the commune. The priests and the politicians were against this and they were trying to find a way to pull him down. A group of people deciding to live in a different way in a commune was really disturbing for many ordinary religious minds in Oregon. Human nature is always suspicious of strangers, so the sannyasins looked like strangers to them. They were disturbed by the commune's way of life, their creativity, their joy, their celebration. There have been interviews of such people and are shown in this documentary. Let's look at Ma Anand Sheila, whose negative influence into the commune has influence into this documentary too, more than Osho himself. As the personal secretary of Osho from 1981 through 1985, she managed Rajneeshpuram. In 1984, Osho ended his 3 years of self-imposed silence. Sheila, who was in power, took advantage of Osho's silence. This is because Osho was not in contact with the sannyasins. While Osho was in isolation and in silence, Sheila had become a celebrity. Through the news media, she had become famous all over the world. She started representing Osho. By the time he was out, Sheila and a group of others had done a whole bunch of calamity, including poisoning, arson, wiretapping, and an attempted murder. The authorities who investigated this saw this as a golden opportunity to destroy the commune entirely. In October 1985, Osho was arrested without warrants along with few others. While the others were released, he was held without bail for 12 days. Subsequent events indicate that it is probable that he was poisoned with the heavy metal thallium while in the jail. Sheila pleaded guilty to fraud, wiretapping, arson, and attempted murder charges and served 2.5 years in federal prison before being deported to another country. The documentary shows interviews with Sheila too. During his self-imposed silence period, Sheila was in the formation of a new religion called Rajneeshism, which was later stopped by Osho. She also wrote a book by the name Book of Rajneeshism and published it under Osho's name. Osho said, "I have been always against all isms because they all become prisons sooner or later. I want my people to be free from any ism." Subsequently, 5,000 copies of the Book of Rajneeshism were burned in fire at the ashram. In 1985, Osho was deported from the United States and he went back to India. He returned to his ashram in Pune and settled down in India in 1986 after being denied permanent entry by multiple countries. The commune, once a thriving utopian experiment, was deserted. The 4,000 people who had worked to turn Rajneeshpuram into an ecologically sound paradise had scattered to the countries from which they had come. The ending of this Netflix documentary series proves there is no such thing as one side to a story. The docu-series only exposes many perspectives on it. Now, few words about Osho. Every few thousand years, an individual appears who irrevocably changes the world around them in many ways that are never immediately apparent except to the most perceptive. Osho is one such individual. His spoken words will resonate for centuries to come. For Osho, all change is individual. There is no society to change. It can only happen to each one of us, one at a time. The thread that runs through all Osho's words is like a love song that we can suddenly, mysteriously hear at just the right moment. And strangely, no matter what the words seem to be referring to, they are only referring to us. And this is no ordinary love song, more an invitation to open our hearts, to hear something beyond the words, beyond the heart, a silence beyond all understanding, where we all belong. If you find this video interesting, please share it with your friends. If this is your first time here, consider subscribing and hit the bell icon so you don't miss a thing. Thank you.